What's up, guys, and welcome back to yet another video here at After Customs. So yeah, guys, today is nothing special again. I will be painting the Nissan's calipers and drums again white because it is in different colors. So I'm just gonna make it look a bit aesthetically appealing. I wanted to take out the sound setup and rewire everything, but I don't think I'm gonna have the time to do that. So yeah, guys, let's get cooking. So yeah, guys, what I have here today is some 360 grit sandpaper. You can use any type of sandpaper to your preference, but this is just some fine sandpaper to my preference. Then I have some masking tape, newspaper to mask up everything else we don't want to get paint on. Then I have the option of going white or what is this color, satin silver lilac. So I think white will do because the car kind of has like a theme going, so I'll take the white. So let's take you out of the equation. So yeah, guys, this is the Rust-Oleum by 2 ultra cover paint and primer. So yeah, guys, let's get cooking. Yeah, guys, so I'm going to be taking off the wheels now and then I'm gonna start the process of painting the front calipers and the rear drums as well. So I'm first gonna sandpaper it off, clean it, and then throw a coat of paint on it or two even, let it dry for a minute, and then put the wheels back on. But before I put the wheels back on, I would like to clean them as well because they're ugly, they're dirty. Oh, this is the part where color wheels, especially light colored wheels, come in for dirt, and especially white cars as well. We try to keep them clean, but okay. But it is winter, and sorry for the light, guys. We do drive a lot, morning and afternoon or evening. I doubt that the caliper is gonna stay clean, but okay, it would be aesthetically appealing. Then I'm gonna try to rectify the bonnet as well because the bonnet is not sitting right. However, I did do the lights, I did realign them. The bumper just needs a slight realignment as well, and then I'm gonna be doing the rear sound. I'm gonna take everything out. You guys are gonna laugh when you see what's in the boot. It's hella, how can I say, tear my car, but okay, guys, so what do you expect? But okay, I'm just gonna try and heaten up everything, clean everything, give the car a wash again, and then I'll be hitting the road again. Okay, so now that the two first wheels are off, I'm just gonna go ahead and clean up both of those, then sandpaper it off, and then from there, guys, let's get masking up and spraying.
guys. Okay, so I finished masking up the first side of the car, so now we're off to respray. So yeah, hope you guys like the content so far. And yeah, just want to show you the paint that I'm using, even though I did show you previously. So this is Rust-Oleum. Guys, I just did a second coat on this one with the Rust-Oleum and it came out pretty darn nice. Okay guys, so basically I'm just gonna clean this wheels while they are off. You guys can see they are hella dirty. Look here, I try to keep these wheels clean as much as I can, as close to new as I can. So yeah guys, here we go. Guys, there you have it. Both that side's wheels are done. That paint should be dry by now, so I'm just gonna go ahead and unmask that, put this in the sun salon, unmask that, and then try to throw them back on. So yeah guys, I'm just busy drying them off quickly, just going the extra mile just to get them nice and clean again, like new. They are actually curb rashless. I try to keep my wheels as neat as possible because I think it's like a pair of shoes, man. Have you ever seen like when you buy a new pair of shoes and you wear it with old clothes, it makes your whole wardrobe change again. So I believe in that. It's but yeah guys, give a like there if you are into Valkyries. I for one love these wheels. I don't think I will change my brand for wheels again. Maybe after this I'll get me a set of Rare CE28s, but you know how hard it is to find a set of these, and I won't actually sell these easy. So you have to persuade me very hard to can buy these wheels off me, knowing that I'm one of very few people that own a set of these. So yeah guys, TE37s for you. It always changes the game. It's the most iconic wheel known to man. So yeah guys, right, I think that should be dry now. So yeah, I don't want to put these wheels on while that is wet, and that would spoil, you know, purchase value. So yeah guys, here we go. Yeah guys, that's how they came out. I'm pretty chuffed of how they look. Show you guys, came out pretty well. Just need to take the masking tape off still. Yes, missions. I didn't cover completely because I couldn't like get the newspaper in there, but I didn't want too much overspray on the brake pad as well. So yeah, I'm pretty chuffed over this job. DIY, and so I do offer the services. I can do it a bit neater, but you know, I'm kind of in a rush. So yeah, let's take this off quickly so you guys can see what the turnout is. It looks okay, looks pretty decent. Right, time to slap on those boys. So yeah guys, that is what it looks like. Pretty chuffed of how it came out. Just the small changes that you need to appreciate on a build, you know. Oh yeah, and I did lower the front a tad bit more because it was a bit too high to my spec. So yeah, I love it. But yeah, guys, I'm just gonna have to turn the car around. As you can see, it's parked close to the wall there, so I'm just gonna have to swap around so I can work more comfortably. Maybe I won't do the next two on video. So yeah, I'm gonna see how they turn out, and I'm gonna show you guys after I've done everything finish, and then we will head off to the boot. That looks ugly, I need to take that off. Then I'm gonna try and work on the boot and see what outcome I get. Yeah guys, I just turned around quickly, and that is pretty much what she looks like without the painted side. That is still a bit too high to my liking, that needs to come lower. So I'm gonna do that when I finish with the repaint of the calipers. I hope you guys like the content so far. So yeah, let's go. Oh, let me just show you in the sunlight what it looks like. Okay, there's not much sunlight though, but it looks nice. Okay, so yeah guys, the wheels are off now, so now it's time to get to prepping and then painting. But I'm not gonna video this, it takes a bit of time, and I still need to do the boot and the realignment of the bonnet. So maybe I'm gonna do that on a later stage, maybe just focus on the boot section. So yeah guys, here we go. So yeah guys, the other side is now complete. Just respray in the camera, pretty nice. Right, so time to clean up the other two again. Go guys, the TEs are all nice and clean. I think it these are dry as well, so yeah, I'm just gonna throw the wheels on, take off all of the wrapping and whatever, throw the wheels on, and then maybe give the car a nice wash again. Oh yeah, I still need to lower that section, so with a bit of YouTube magic we should be done. And guys, while I was busy you know, cleaning the car up, two of my friends popped up, and man, oh man, I must say that lady 323, or I don't know if it's a Ford Tracer or something, but I'm gonna throw some clips in for y'all so you can see what damage that car does. And he hasn't even tested the car on a DB reader yet, but it sounds insane. So yeah guys, I'm gonna get back to finishing up the Sentra, and then yeah, I'll be showing you the clips. I'm gonna do one and me with some other shit. That's it, I said, next time.